Hi, my name is Terry Rice. I'm a biz dev consultant and staff writer here at Entrepreneur Magazine. And today we're joined by Alyssa Monroe, who has a few questions about growing her business. Alyssa, welcome.
Hi, Terry. Thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to speak with you.
Awesome. So how about you tell me and everyone else a little bit about your business?
Yeah, so I run a digital first marketing and communications firm specifically for beauty and lifestyle brands and the creators who lead them. So my first question is about operating again in a virtual environment. So how do you keep employees motivated and engaged virtually during the ebbs and flows of your startup?
I think the first thing is to be extremely honest about how things are going, right? Because if you're not, then there's this rumor mill that starts up, like, are we starting up? Or are we shutting down? What's going on? So the more honest you are, even if it's bad news, the better. But also just creating a culture of collaboration, but not in the way where you're doing happy hours where everyone talks about work. Find ways for people to connect with each other on a one-on-one basis. So maybe it's a Ring Central chat where they're talking, but they're not allowed to talk about work whatsoever. That way they're forming more interpersonal bonds, the same one that you used to get at a water cooler. We're now reproducing that virtually.
That makes a lot of sense and very helpful because, as you know, you just want to retain the best and greatest talent. So thank you. So my next question is, as we continue to grow and scale, how do we continue to succeed as a completely virtual company, knowing that some competitors and agencies are moving back to office?
I feel that being remote is actually a strength for a few reasons. One is you can draw from a larger talent pool, right? If you live in Brooklyn, you can hire people who are from anywhere across the world. So you have more options in regards to talent. It's also more affordable. So you can actually charge less because you don't have as much overhead by way of rent. And then lastly, you know, if you do want to actually interact with people in person, you can always do a visit, right? So if a client's like, oh, we prefer in-person, great. You can hop on a plane, right? You can just drive wherever they are. So it's not to say that you're never going to see them in person. It's just your team is dispersed and you collaborate remotely.
So my last question is, where do you see service-based companies going in the future? Do you feel that virtual-based companies are better situated than in-office companies? I think you answered that a little bit before, too.
Yeah, well, I'll say this. I mean, work and workplace have been decoupled like no time in history due to the pandemic. So if you cannot operate remotely, you're at a disadvantage, right? Because the whole brick and mortar thing, that's what we used to do. But now we realize it doesn't work as well as we thought it did, right? Because you're sacrificing your work-life balance, you're sacrificing your health in many occasions. So you'll have people that are more happy, more fulfilled, and even more acknowledged due to the fact that you're operating remotely as opposed to working in person.
That's a good point.
I'm a little bit biased because I prefer to work remotely, but if you think about it, that's now a sticking point for people when they're looking for jobs. What's the work environment? Is it remote? Is it hybrid? Is it in person? And I feel strongly that any company who stresses in person, they're going to have a challenge attracting the top talent because people who are very talented have options, right? So if they don't want to work in person, they're not going to. So this outdated model that we have to do everything in person, that we can't collaborate unless we're right in front of each other, that's going to hurt any company who adopts that approach. Anyone who wants to go more remote and offer more flexibility, they're going to succeed and they're going to scale much faster.
100%. I couldn't agree more.
Realize that if you have younger employees, their dream might have been to work in an office and be by that water cooler and rub elbows with their coworkers. So how do you reproduce that in a more virtual format? And again, that goes back to these one-on-one calls they're having. Maybe it could be some kind of challenge even, like, hey, let's do this challenge to see who can get the most steps in this week. That way you're not stuck at your desk all day. But the more you can recreate a culture, an office culture remotely, where people feel comfortable talking to individuals who are not on their team or a few levels above them, the more successful you'll be. And again, if you just stress this culture and this openness, you'll be able to activate and get the most out of all these new employees who maybe were planning on being in the office once they graduated, and that's not the case right now.
Very true. Very true. Thank you so much again, Terry, for speaking with me and lending your advice to my startup.
Yeah. Happy to do so. And just remember that being remote, being virtual is a strength because you have more flexibility and you have access to a larger talent pool. But it's on you to recreate a culture that would have occurred in-house. And again, I recommend doing things that are non-work related. So some kind of physical activity or some kind of weekly challenge. That way, everyone will get to know each other, politely compete with each other, but also celebrate wins together as well.
Awesome.